Hello everyone. My name is Bright. I'm a developer of Wildchain. Today I'm going to explain you what Wildchain is. Okay, so Wildchain is actually a digital collectible mobile game for conservation. It's very easy to play. Okay, so the player needs to buy a magic egg, and these eggs will hatch into a baby animals. For example, baby cheetah. And the player can raise this cheetah, like buy them food, buy them shelter, and the cheetah will in turn grows into an adult animal like this. Okay, and these animals that are in the game is actually a digital mirror of the actual animals in the real world. For example, if there are 6,000 cheetah in the real world, then there are equal number, which is 6,000 number of cheetah in the game as well. And all the profits that we get from the game, the player pay for the food or anything that they pay during the game, 100% of the profits will go fund the conservation project that will in turn support the animals that the players have in the game. And in order to make the players feel secure that the money that they pay to the game actually goes to conservation project, we choose to use blockchain for transparency. Now that we know what Wildchain is, let's take a look at the system architecture of Wildchain and all the open source library that we're going to use for this project. Okay, so this is the overview of Wildchain architecture. So we have the client, blockchain, API, and database. For client, the client connects to all three components. The client will connect to blockchain to store all the data that are needed for transparency. And as blockchain is not very good in performance, like so we separate some of the data that are not needed to store in blockchain to store in database instead. And the client will also connect to API, which will control the logic of the game. The API will also connect to database and blockchain to get or set data for the game. Now let's go over one by one. For client, we choose to use React Native because React Native is a cross-platform. We don't need to develop the application two times for Android or iOS. We just use React Native. And another reason is that React Native is based on JavaScript. And in order for client to connect to blockchain, we use the JavaScript library called Web3 JavaScript. And we also use IPFS HTTP client library to let the client connect to IPFS database. As for gaming graphic, we use Unity. In order to make Unity and React Native work together, we use an open source library called React Native Unity. Next, let's take a look at database. For database, we chose to use IPFS because IPFS encourages people to store data in a decentralized way. So if the data is stored in many, many nodes, then if one of the nodes died out, then we still have other nodes to replace. And as there are many nodes, so it's harder for hacker to hack the database. Next up is API. So for API, we use Node.js. And as it is easy to set up and it's JavaScript framework, we chose to use JavaScript framework for the same reason that we chose to use React Native, because we need API to connect to blockchain and IPFS database. As for blockchain, we choose to use Ethereum chain and token standard of ERC721X. We chose to use Ethereum because Ethereum chain has smart contract, so we can write the smart contract so that people can come and check our code that the money that the player pays for our game actually goes to supports the conservation project. That's all I have for today. And Wildchain is very early stage of development, and we still need developer resources. If anyone is interested in joining Wildchain, so please let me know. For more information, if you want to know about Wildchain, please go to website wildchain.io. Thank you.